John, when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord,' as the prophet Isaiah said." Now they had been sent from the Pharisees, and they asked him, "Why then are you baptizing if you are neither the Messiah nor Elijah nor the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water. Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." And this took place in Bethany, across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from our living God and from our newborn Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. In our gospel lesson today, we see a side of John the Baptist that we don't see necessarily in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke. If you remember, in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, we see the hellfire and brimstone John, the John who calls everyone a brood of vipers and who announces that they must repent and be forgiven of their sins. In Matthew, Mark, and Luke, we see John the Baptist as we might think of one of the great revival preachers from the 1800s, from one of the camp meetings like a Charles Finney or a Francis Asbury, a John the Baptist who has listed everyone's sins and wants to hold them out in front of them. I was going to try and do that today. The problem is I started with Bill Shoup and it just got too long. Never got around to anybody else. But today we have a John who is more a kinder and gentler John, if you will. A John who doesn't come preaching hellfire and brimstone, but a John who says that his purpose is to point to Jesus. That he is the one in the wilderness, the voice crying out in the wilderness who prepares the way for the Lord. And he does that by